Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me, I am fit as a fiddle and ready to roll. Thanks for asking. Actually, I'm not entirely certain that I am fit as a fiddle because I don't know what that term means. I don't know what the fiddle's fitness level is or how I would compare to that level of fitness. So I'm not entirely certain that that was accurate. What I am certain of, however, is we have a great show today. We are going to take a look at four browser extensions that I use each and every day on Ask Dotto Tech. You know, our web browsing experience would be far less rich were it not for these browser extensions, which we are about to look at today. Now, it doesn't matter which web browser you use. I'm going to be showing you today in Chrome, but the same premises apply to Firefox, Safari, to all web browsers. Within your browser, you can add functionality through browser extensions, and you see mine here in the upper right-hand side of my browser. This is a quick pick area where I can quickly jump in and use any of the different extensions that I've added. We add those extensions in a couple of different ways within our web browser, but in Chrome, for example, we go into the preferences, go into extensions there, and here you can either, by scrolling down to the bottom, you can add new extensions by searching for more, and you can enable or disable the extensions that you've installed. Now, you can see I have a lot of them. That's because I test out a lot of different browser extensions, and a few stay and become part of my everyday workflow. That is what I'm going to share with you today, the four ones that I know that I use each and every day. And we're going to start things out by looking at LastPass. Now, LastPass is my password manager. Now, LastPass is just one of three or four great password managers you can choose from. And frankly, I don't care which one you use. I care that you use a password manager. It is your first and best and most important level of security, having good, robust passwords for all of your internet browsing. And LastPass manages all of my passwords very elegantly and allows me to create good cryptic passwords that protect my privacy and security when I'm online. But the challenge with having great passwords is then how do you remember them when you go to log into these services? That's what LastPass does when we've installed it here as a browser extension. It continuously runs in the background, monitoring our activity, and when we visit a website that requires one of our passwords to be used, it pops up and says, "Hey, Steve, I've got the password for that. Do you want me to let you in? Allow me to show you." Let's jump over to Google, and I haven't signed into Google. Now, I actually have a whole bunch of different Google accounts, which makes it even that much more confusing, but watch how elegantly LastPass deals with that situation. I click on Sign In, and Google pops up my different accounts that I can sign in with. I'm going to choose the account that I want to sign in with, but I don't know the password. I can't remember it, frankly. But if I look here on the right-hand side, I see the little LastPass icon. If I click on that, it brings up my different options for signing into my Google accounts. Now, I've got more than one Google account because I've got demo accounts, and I also have some family member accounts that I go in and fix things up for them occasionally when they break things. So I've got a few different logins here. But the easiest way and quickest way for me to now log in is simply clicking on the account that I want to log in with, the ID I want to log in with, and sign in, and LastPass takes care of populating in the password and taking care of it for us. So now I'm in, and I can head over to Gmail, take a look, and I can work within this Google account that I just signed in with. LastPass to me is an absolutely essential tool. Occasionally, you're going to want to go in and you're going to want to manage your LastPass account, and you can do that directly just by clicking here on the icon, and that brings you into the management console to allow you to generate new passwords or go in and look at your existing ones, decide which ones might be stale that you might want to change. LastPass will do all of those sorts of things for you. It, to me, is an essential tool. By all means, if LastPass doesn't float your boat, use Dashlane or use 1Password or another of the great password managers we have. But choose one and use one. That is my plea to you. The next tool I have shown you so many times, I'm not going to spend too much time on it today, but I can't talk about browser extensions without talking about the Evernote Web Clipper, which is a tool that I probably use more than any. When I'm researching information online, when I'm going through and trying to find all of the different stories and the different details for the videos that I create or for different social sharing, I'm constantly clipping and saving information from the internet, and I use the Evernote Web Clipper to allow me to clip articles and save them to my Evernote account so that I can use them a little bit later. This is my digital assistant. This is the almost my digital brain, where all of the different little bits of facts and information that I need to store, I collect using the Evernote Web Clipper. And I've done plenty of videos on that, so I'm not going to spend too much time on the Evernote Web Clipper other than to say it is one of the four. Now, if you follow my newsletter or follow me on social media, you might notice that I have a bit of a habit of making typos and the odd spelling mistake. It's something that I quite frankly feel quite bad about. It's a combination of reasons that I have all of these issues. One of them is that I'm just a crummy speller, but I'm also always in a rush. And as we're a very small team, which is basically me and another half a person sometimes. So when I send stuff out, if I'm in a rush, it doesn't get proofread as well as it should. And that does embarrass me a little bit. And frankly, some of the letters that you've sent to me are hurtful. They've affected me in my happy place. So I am bound and determined to fix that. And this is the tool that is helping me more than any. I've used a lot of different online spell checkers and grammar checkers, but Grammarly keeps bubbling to the top. And they've got this new extension, which is really making a difference for me. This Grammarly extension right here basically monitors all of my different, text fields when I'm on the web typing in, and it gives me corrections. Now, I've used other tools that getting to the corrections isn't quite as elegant as it is in Grammarly. Allow me to show you, because it is actually pretty sweet. If I just go into a document that I'm working on and writing, we can see that there are a variety of different spelling and grammatical errors in this document. And this is what I like now about how Grammarly works. As I roll my cursor over top of the spelling errors, I don't even have to right click on it. It pops up suggestions, and it does so very elegantly. So I can just pop it up. I can see exactly what it's suggesting, select the correction, and then move on to the next correction that I need to have. Here we have a grammatical correction where it says we should have a comma. Now, whether or not it's 1,000% accurate as far as its punctuation suggestions, occasionally you're going to want to override it. It does help, and it gets you thinking about the flow of the text that you're in, and it does it constantly. That constant monitoring I start to rely on. Now, here's where it's becoming far more valuable is when we're doing quick little posts into things like Facebook or Twitter. So here I have a post that I'm preparing in Facebook, and I've made a couple of errors on purpose, but you can see that Grammarly is going through. It gives me actual a summary of the issues right here, but again, allows me to roll over top and quickly make a correction on both grammar and spelling right within Grammarly. Now, if we need more correction, I use Grammarly also has a web client that does far more than this kind of quick tertiary checking of your information, but this saves me increasingly is saving me from embarrassment and just making my communications seem that much more professional. Going to Twitter, we've got the exact same stuff happening here, the exact same interface. The Grammarly web plugin is turning out to be a boon for me. So that's three. We've got LastPass, Evernote, Grammarly, and finally, I'm increasingly doing a lot of sharing, especially in Twitter. My Twitter presence has been growing a lot over the last little while, mainly because I've been doing so much work on Blab, but I digress. Consequently, I'm sharing far more information than ever before online, so I'm having to shorten a lot of URLs and links of things that I'm sharing. And of course, the standard for doing that is Bitly. Well, Bitly has got a browser extension that you can plug in that allows you to go to any website. So let's just go to the Dotto Tech site. Let's go into our course. Let's go into the Slack Made Easy course. If I wanted to grab this URL and share it in a shortened form, and I was just browsing to Steve's site, I can use the Bitly tool here just by clicking on Bitly, and it's very cool. I've configured it so that it automatically copies this new Bitly link to my clipboard as soon as I click on that. Now, it'll save this link here for me to track the effect of the link a little bit later, and you can actually customize the link, and it gives you access to some of the most common Bitly tools here. But primarily, using this browser extension, you click on the Bitly browser extension. Now, next time you paste, or on your clipboard, if you watch, you'll see the Bitly version. Oh, actually, let me do it this way. I'm going to go into Twitter. Let's go back into that post that I was creating. Let's say that I wanted to add a link. Do you see now it's adding the shortened Bitly link to the page instead of the full URL? This is, again, a tool that it just saves me a lot of time. I used to go into Bitly, launch the website, go in and create the link, and it was only a couple of clicks. But now it's a single click and it's done. So it saves me over time an awful lot of cycles. And it also makes it more convenient. So it makes it so that I want to share a little bit more as we're going on as well. So those are my four tools that I use every day. Browser extensions, LastPass, Evernote Web Clipper, Grammarly spell and grammar checking, and finally, Bitly link shortening. I hope you found this video today to be useful. Now remember, there's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. The second is I encourage you to subscribe to our newsletter. Then you'll hear about all of our live events, like our live blabs, our live webinars and trainings that we have coming out. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site supported by you through our crowdfunding site, Patreon. If you want to find out what patronage in Dotto Tech entails and the perks that come back to you, which are indeed awesome, I encourage you to drop by and have a look at our Patreon page. Those of you who are my patrons, thank you so much for your ongoing support. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.